You've had your heart broken. Whether it's due to a rejection, a breakup, or some kind of loss, the pain hurts all the same. A broken heart is one of those circumstances that immediately demands attention for an individual that is likely all they can think about. The events leading up to the heartbreak, and of course, the aftermath. Indeed, with the sorrow now well established, it is evident that a person going through this struggle wishes the pain would disappear. This remedy, an effective mechanism to vanish the sorrow of heartbreak, what is it, and where can it be found? Further still, is there a true remedy for a broken heart? Or are there only solutions to treat the symptoms, rather than address the problem's core? Today's video will undertake the task of finding a viable solution for something that everyone has likely experienced at some point, heartbreak. The examination will not investigate why heartbreak occurs, but rather, whether there are any effective remedies for the affliction and just how effective each one may be. Note that some remedies are certainly better than others. Namely, they are far more constructive when compared to destructive alternatives. To begin, whenever anyone experiences suffering, they seek a solution to their pain. A remedy is sought after because of its potential to alleviate the pain. Now, the consequences of a specific remedy may be taken into consideration, like harmful side effects, but they will not be taken as seriously as they initially should be. Why? The answer should be obvious, because the number one priority of a person afflicted with pain is to extinguish that pain as soon as possible. Pain is a fickle thing. It demands to be felt and will continue to affect a person until the root cause is addressed. It will even break down individuals with the most robust constitutions, given enough time. Pain is subjective, and its severity depends on the person, but nobody, regardless of how strong they may seem, can last forever. At some point, they will demand a solution to their affliction because it is all they can think about. Acknowledging this as true means that long-term detrimental solutions will present themselves as immediate remedies. What comes to mind are drugs like opioid painkillers and alcohol, among others. It was aforementioned that some remedies are worse than others. Painkillers and alcohol would most certainly fall under the detrimental category. But why, you may ask? Why indeed? After all, painkillers are meant to alleviate pain, hence their classification. Alcohol, at first glance, may also seem like a good place to forget the pain. Even so, both options are short-term remedies that carry a heavy toll in the long run. A common idiom associated with alcohol consumption is, "Drown your sorrows." This is where a person induces intoxication, hoping to forget their affliction. Resorting to alcohol or drugs to alleviate the pain of heartbreak and other similar distresses is not a constructive option. One may believe these remedies are indeed the best solutions. However, like many delusions, they have a time limit, and once the fantasy disappears, reality sets in like a brick wall. The long-term consequences of using painkillers and alcohol for pain relief are far too severe to grant any merit as valid solutions. If this is true, then why do people resort to these destructive options? Put simply, it is because of their relative ease of access, and the illusion of pain relief is strong enough to delude individuals into thinking they are working. The inevitable cycle is that of one prolonging a problem rather than addressing it head-on. By the time the delusion is discovered, it may already be too late. Switching to a more positive section now, the constructive remedies for heartbreak will be discussed. One of these remedies is thought to be time, more specifically, the passage of time. Seneca, the ancient Roman philosopher, is attributed to the quote, "Only time can heal what reason cannot." Indeed, time can be a valuable healer, but only if it is utilized correctly. What do you mean by correctly? Well, time will not be an effective remedy if you spend all of it wallowing in your own sorrow or constantly thinking about the heartbreak. The key message of time as a remedy is that with its passage, the probability is greater that other endeavors will occupy your mind. You will be forced to move on in some capacity, as current worries will hijack your mind's attention. This is not asserting that you will completely forget the heartbreak, but rather, it is to say that the probability will be greater of it becoming a more out-of-sight, out-of-mind phenomenon. People who advocate for time as an effective remedy have likely gone through the process themselves. What they really mean is that the pain does not vanish. You just learn to live with it. Very much so. A person has to cope and understand that it may not go away completely, but they refuse to let it dominate their life. At this point, you may agree and say, yes, I believe time is an effective remedy for heartbreak. Or you may refuse and believe that time is not an effective solution. I am not convinced and hope you will offer another one, you may say. All right then, how about this? The conundrum that rests within heartbreak is that a person becomes so fixated about it. If they placed all of their eggs in one basket by hoping to get romantically involved with another, for example, but this ultimately failed, then they exacerbate their situation. They have become stuck in a scarcity mindset in that regard. The best remedy for heartbreak, or as close as one can arrive to the best, is that of changing your perception from that of scarcity to abundance. Additionally, the realization must be made that life is greater than a lone rejection, failure, or heartbreak. With romantic endeavors, people become fixated on one individual. I need to end up with them, or I cannot see myself with anyone else, they think. These disastrous thoughts and expectations lead these people astray because once their expectations fail them, then what do? They do not know, and this perpetuates the extent of the pain they feel. So, how do you prevent this from happening, or in the very least, reduce heartbreak's aftermath with its repercussions? The answer lies in realizing that the one person who broke your heart is not the one for you. Furthermore, there is far more to life than obsessing over them. You still have goals, dreams, and aspirations, don't you? The fact of the matter is that people will hurt you no matter what. People hurt each other merely by existing. In the case of the person who caused the heartbreak, they are simply another manifestation of suffering. It all begins and ends with you. How you let it affect your person is what determines how you will emerge from the experience. To truly alleviate the pain of heartbreak, you have to be grounded in your purpose, your true purpose. You may think that the person who broke your heart was your purpose. No, they were not. You were deceived into thinking they were. Think harder. Remind yourself of your higher calling, the purpose that compels you to get out of bed every day. If that is hitting the gym, so be it. If that is getting the best grades in school, so be it. If that is serving your community, so be it. Regardless of what your calling is, the point is that heartbreak, like many emotional pains, last only as long as you permit them to. If you ponder about it constantly, then it will remain in your mind constantly. But if you return to your purpose, get back to your life, then you will expedite the recovery process. Do not put so much stock in one person that you will become devastated if they leave. People may come and go, but you will be the sole constant. At the end of the day, you are all that is left. So, take care of yourself, alright? Perceive yourself as an outside caretaker responsible for your mind and body. Would you let yourself fall into disrepair? Of course not, because if you did, then you would suffer the consequences. Ensure that you are your first priority and that your mission comes first. Do not let anyone steal your peace, your satisfaction, and happiness away from you. Ladies and gentlemen, heartbreak can be overcome. All it takes is the willingness to let go and shift your focus onto more prosperous pursuits. To be clear, and to repeat once again, the best remedy for managing heartbreak and other similar afflictions is to realize that there is more to life than heartbreak. There is so much work to be done, so much progress to be made. You can come back from it if you allow yourself not to be dragged down. Focus on your goals and aspirations. Engage in activities that bring you satisfaction. Stay productive and occupy your mind with positive endeavors. Because if you do, then you will find that the pain was not so bad. Who knows? Maybe you will learn something and grow from the experience as well. In order to fully appreciate the sunshine, one must learn to walk in the rain.